Glory to God. Okay, I'm still talking to this one. I want to talk about is I want to appeal to any nation, any country, any family that is still circumcising women to stop it. It's a very, very big offense, and it's a very big damage to women. In the Bible, God said to Abraham, it's only the male child that God instructed that the children of Israel should circumcise the male children to remove the first skin, you know, the first skin, that thing that covers the penis. I don't know whether you have seen somebody who is not circumcised, you see how it looked like. God instructed the children of Israel, instructed his own children to remove the foreskin, you know, that covered the mouth of penis, of the male child, of the male children. God did not in any way, read Bible from Genesis to Revelation, you will never see or hear God talking about women. Where did this thing come from? Where did this evil come from? That this is a very big, you know, very big assault, a very big evil and wickedness upon women. Because anything that God did not commanded we, the men and the women, the people that he created in his own image, human being, we are created in the image of God. So we are being controlled by what God said, the instruction given to us by our maker, by our creator. So any other thing outside this is evil, is wickedness, is lawlessness, is evil. Let me put it like this. I am appealing to any nation that is still cutting the clitoris of women to please, I am advising you to stop. To stop. You are just being wicked to women. You're just being wicked to that girl. You're just being wicked to that beautiful girl that you are cutting off the thing that God gave to her for her enjoyment. If you cut off that clitoris, you have cut off the sweetest thing God have given that girl, that beautiful girl. It pains me. Let me give you one thing before so you have to understand. Even in this Germany, there is one Igbo family that I was staying with. This is Igbo people from Nigeria. They gave birth to a female child, to a girl. One of the brother of the man came to visit. I hear him instructing his brother to make sure that they circumcise that little girl. I was in their house then when I came to Germany, you know, when I came new. I hear that. I say, what did you just say? I was very, very angry in the inside. When I hear that, I said, what did you just say? In this Western world, in this place that you can see, not that maybe you're living in Africa, you are talking about something like this here. I was very, very angry for them. But thank God, finally, they did not do it. They did not do it. But I still understand today, some families in Nigeria is still doing it. Even some eastern part or Edo or that part. I just hear that some part are still doing it in Nigeria, and some other part of the world or other countries of the world that there are some part that is still doing this, that is still doing this atrocity, I call it atrocity, doing this evil to women. Please, I advise you, please, God did not instruct us to circumcise women. It is only the male child that God instructed for us, for his children, to circumcise the male child, to remove the foreskin. It's a covenant God made with Abraham. So I don't want you to continue doing that evil. It is a very, 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 very big evil. Because that girl, if you cut off that clitoris, if you remove it, she will not be able to enjoy sex. She will not be able to enjoy sex. So many ladies out there, their most sensitive part is that clitoris. They are just touching it. You stay that you turn them on. They are ready. They are ready. So when you cut it off, maybe this is the only part that God has given her that will help her to enjoy the intimacy, to enjoy the love making, to enjoy their husband. Then you cut it off. That girl's body becomes deadened. She doesn't know, she doesn't enjoy it, she doesn't enjoy the sex. Even the man will be doing everything, nothing. Because the thing that's supposed to turn her on and make her to enjoy the thing is not there. So I advise any nation, any country, any family that is still doing this evil, that is still thinking this evil to ladies, to girls, to stop it. To stop it. It's an abomination. It's an evil. In the body of a woman, that clitoris plays important role when it comes to love making. It makes the woman to feel the womanhood, to feel I am a woman. It makes them to feel that, yes, to feel the woman they are. Okay, so this is what I just want to pass across. Please help me and spread this video. If you know anybody that is still doing this or any village or any way they are still doing this, please let all of us stand up and say no to this. It is not a good thing. Not a good thing. Okay, so I'm so happy as you hear this now. Please try to educate other people, because so many people, especially African countries, they are still backward thinking in a negative ways. You know, one family was saying that any lady or that did not circumcise is always threatened. It's a lie. Even the one that they cut off that they circumcised, we fret more, because she will be searching to really know to get the sweetness, because she will not be enjoying the thing. No, but when a lady is full, everything is intact, everything is okay, everything is intact. No. She will enjoy it, and after everything, yes, she'll be satisfied. I don't know why people think like that. I don't know the thing that brings such a thing to them. Cutting off something that is not supposed to be, cutting off something that is meant for sweetness, meant for enjoyment, meant for the woman to enjoy the something. And please let us stand and say no to this. Not good.